Sairam students, welcome back. Today we are going ahead with our third part of our fifth lesson in geography, that is winds. Okay, now in the first part, what did we learn? In our first part, we learned about the planetary winds. Those are the westerlies, the easterlies and the polar winds, right? And in our second part, we learned about the local winds, the land breeze, the sea breeze and the seasonal winds, right? Now in today's part, we will be going ahead and concluding with the lesson today. So what are we going to learn today? We are going to learn about the winds which are destructive. Yes, one of the kind of winds which is destructive, those are the cyclones. Yes, you must have heard about the cyclones and even seen it on the television also. Okay, so what is a cyclone? What are the conditions or factors responsible for a cyclone to occur? Fine. Cyclonic conditions are created when a low pressure area is surrounded by a high pressure area. Yes. Now, when does a cyclonic condition take place? When a low pressure area is surrounded by a high pressure area. You know what is a low pressure area? A low pressure area is where the temperature is high and the pressure is low. Yes. And a high pressure area is where the temperature is low and the pressure air pressure is high. That's the way it is. Or it can also be where it is at a higher altitude. If you go to a higher altitude, the air pressure increases, whereas in the decreases, whereas in the lower altitudes it is high. Fine. So when we are learning about cyclones, low pressure area is surrounded by high pressure area, and that time the cyclonic conditions are created. In such conditions, what happens? The winds blow from the high pressure area towards the low pressure area. Yes, so winds start blowing towards the low pressure area from the high air pressure area. Yes, so the low pressure area which is being surrounded by high pressure area, so over there the winds from the surrounded air high pressure area will start moving or start blowing towards the low pressure area. Fine. Now what, see, you can see over here, children, over here you can see this is the low pressure area over here, high pressure, which is surrounded by high pressure area. Yes, so what happens in such conditions is that the winds will start blowing from the high pressure to the low pressure, from high pressure to low pressure areas. Fine. Okay, now because of this, due to the rotation of the earth, the cyclonic winds in the northern hemisphere, they move in an anti-clockwise direction, whereas they move in a clockwise direction in the southern hemisphere. Okay, now we'll just see this, how it is anti-clockwise and clockwise. Okay, fine. So this is our earth, just assume this is our earth. Okay, so this is the northern hemisphere, this is the southern hemisphere. So cyclonic winds, how are they going to move in the northern hemisphere? So they will move in an anti-clockwise direction, whereas in a southern hemisphere, it will move in the clockwise direction. You all know what is clockwise and anti-clockwise. Clockwise means it will go, when you look at the time, it moves from, first it's 1 o'clock, 2, 3, 4, 5, it's that way. And anti-clockwise means the other way around, 12, 11, 9, 10, 9, 8, 7, that way. Okay, so the rotation, because of the rotation of the earth, the cyclonic winds in the northern hemisphere, they move in an anti-clockwise direction, whereas in the southern hemisphere, it will go in a clockwise direction. Fine. I hope this is clear to you, children. Moving ahead. Now, what are the conditions during a cyclone? What happens during a cyclone? Yes. So, during a cyclone, the skies are cloudy. The sky is cloudy. Winds blow with high velocity and it rains heavily. So these are the conditions which prevail during a cyclone. Yes, because what happens, the because of the winds which are blowing with high velocity, clouds get in the sky, it rains heavily, and these types of winds or cyclones, they are destructive. Yes, we will see as to how they can be destructive also. So the areas which are affected by the cyclone is limited, and we are also not sure as to what will be the duration, the velocity, the direction and place of origin of these winds is unpredictable. You cannot predict it. Yes. So the area affected by the cyclones is limited, the duration, the velocities, direction and place of origin of these winds is unpredictable. Okay, now children, the other thing is that when they, you see these cyclones, when they're shown on the weather maps, they are represented by the letter L. Yes, you must have seen your physical map, your political map also. So where you see where they can, they show, they have those things to show, the symbols to show whether it's a mountain, they show a triangle, whether it's a peak, okay, they show a river, is shown through some symbol, or railways, a railway line is shown through the railway tracks. All those are seen on a map. So similarly, on the weather maps which are there, so on these maps the center of cyclone is represented by the letter L. Yes, so the center of cyclone is represented by the letter L on the weather maps, and a cyclone system moves from one place to another. Yes, a cyclone system moves from one place to another in that limited region only, because when we learn, see that the areas which are affected by cyclone is limited, so this system keeps moving from one place to another in that limited region only, or limited area only. Fine, you can see these cyclonic storms. Okay, now these cyclonic storms they occurring in the western part of the Pacific Ocean along the coasts of Japan, China and Philippines are known as typhoons. Okay, and these storms arise in the month of from June to October. So when we have the rainy season, isn't it, we have get the rainy rains during this, the monsoon season during June to September. So during this, these months, the these cyclonic storms, they occur in the western part of the Pacific Ocean, that is near the western near the coast of Japan, China and Philippines, and over here they are called as the typhoons. Okay, now since they are, these cyclones are blowing with high velocity and heavy rains, they prove to be destructive. Yes, so when these type of cyclonic storms do occur in the Pacific Ocean, or they blow over the Pacific Ocean, they are destructive. It can be a, there can be a loss of life as well as property. Okay, now this we are talking about the western part of the Pacific Ocean, whereas these cyclones in the Caribbean Sea are known as hurricanes. Okay, and these are also destructive in nature. Now during these storms, the minimum velocity of the wind is 60 km per hour. Yes, so we have already learned that wind is measured in the unit of knots or kilometer per hour. So the minimum velocity, yes, the minimum velocity of these winds is 60 kilometers per hour. And the cyclones which originate in the temperate zones, yes, they are not so powerful and hence are not destructive. Then what are they called? Yes, since they are not that powerful and they are not destructive, then they emerge, they originate in the temperate zone. But the cyclones which we, which are destructive, we don't know the duration, the velocity, and also we do not, it's very difficult to predict the center of the origin of these winds. Yes, but in temperate zones they do originate, but they are not powerful nor destructive. Fine, so what are they called? The next one, anticyclones, just the opposite of cyclones. Yes, like you say, synonyms and antonyms, antonyms. So those are the opposites. So the opposite of cyclones is anticyclones. Cyclones are destructive, they blow with high velocity, isn't it? So just the opposite, anticyclones are pleasant, they do not, they blow with lesser velocity, their skies are clear, there is no rainfall, the weather is pleasant. But what are the conditions during an anticyclone? Fine, under specific atmospheric conditions, the air pressure in a particular area increases. Yes, and the pressure in the surrounding areas remains low. Yes, so in a particular, see, in a particular region the air pressure increases and the surrounding area remains low, whereas in cyclones we learned that the low pressure area is surrounded by high pressure area, isn't it? Over here, the high pressure area, yes, the high pressure area, the air region where the air the pressure increases is surrounded by the area where the pressure remains low. So what happens next? So what will happen over here? The winds will blow from the center towards the surrounding areas in a circular manner. Yes, whereas in cyclones we saw that the winds blow from the high pressure area to the low pressure area. isn't it? Over here, yes, so in a, what will happen, the pressure which is there, the high pressure which is there, so from over here, this the air pressure will blow from the center where the area is having high pressure. So from there it will blow towards the surrounding areas in a circular manner. Fine. And unlike the cyclones, the anticyclones in the northern hemisphere blow in the clockwise direction, whereas in the southern hemisphere they blow in an anticlockwise direction. Okay, we'll do this again. The anticyclones, okay, in the northern hemisphere, yes, the anticyclones in the northern hemisphere, this is the northern hemisphere and this is the southern hemisphere, right? So the anticyclones in the northern hemisphere will blow in a clockwise direction, and in the southern hemisphere will blow in the anticlockwise direction. Is it clear? Fine. So this is how the anticyclones blow. The anticyclones in the northern hemisphere will blow in a clockwise direction, whereas in the southern hemisphere it will blow in an anticlockwise direction. I hope this is clear. Fine. Moving ahead, during anticyclones, the skies are clear, winds blow with lesser velocities and weather is pleasant. Yes, just the opposite of cyclones. Cyclones, skies are cloudy, winds blow with higher velocity and it starts raining. Whereas in anticyclones, the skies are clear, winds blow with lesser velocities and weather is pleasant. Fine. They last for a few days. So these anticyclones, they do not last for a longer period, they last for a few days, and they originate in temperate zones, and on the weather maps they are denoted, or these anticyclones are, the center of these anticyclones are represented by the letter H. Okay, the center of an anticyclone is represented by the letter H, whereas the center of cyclones is represented by the letter L. Anticyclones are vividly experienced in high pressure belts. So whether you experience anticyclones, you experience anticyclones in the high pressure belts, right? And the rainfall in these area is low, as winds in these areas are always moving out. So the regions where anticyclones are experienced, okay, the temperate zone, so over there the rainfall is less because the winds keep on moving, always moving out. The winds are always moving out, they're not coming in, they're moving out. That is why these areas receive less rainfall. Fine. I think this is clear to you children about cyclones and anticyclones. Yes, isn't it clear? Okay, so cyclones, the condition is such that the low pressure areas are surrounded by the high pressure area and winds blow from the high pressure area towards the low pressure area. Yes, during the cyclones, the skies are cloudy, it rains heavily, winds blow with high velocity. And during the cyclones, the winds blow in the northern hemisphere, they blow in an anticlockwise direction, whereas in the southern hemisphere, they blow in a clockwise direction. In anticyclones, the atmospheric conditions are such that in a particular region, the air pressure increases, and the surrounding area, the air pressure is low. So what happens? The winds are moving out from the high pressure area to the low pressure area. Under such circumstances, the condition during an anticyclone is that the skies are clear, the winds blow with lesser velocity and the weather is pleasant. Cyclones are denoted by, are represented by letter L, and anticyclones are represented by the letter H on the weather maps, the center of cyclones and anticyclones. Okay, so that is what we have learned in our today's part about cyclones and anticyclones. So in our next part, we will revise the lesson, the full lesson again, from the beginning till what we have learned today. In brief, we will be doing that in our next part. So till then, stay safe, have a good day. Sai Ram, children.